Hi, I'm Matt Jackson, and I'm here with Gym Club Solutions today, and we're going to be looking at the handspring vault. Hi, so we're going to look at starting the preparations for handspring vault. One of the first things we're going to look at is how we contact the springboard and how we swing our arms to contact the vault. So I'm going to demonstrate the exercise, and then the gymnasts are going to have a go too. So we're going to use a soft block today, and we're going to kneel in front of the block, and we're going to create the angle that we want to jump on the springboard. So we're going to start on our knees today purposely, and we're going to try and get an angle between our knees and our shoulders and hips to be in a nice stiff line. So when we jump onto the springboard, we want to create body stiffness and also have our arms behind us. The reason we have our arms behind us is so we can get a good arm swing to block into the vaulting table to create the height we want off the top of the vault. So we're going to go in front of the block, have a nice lean backwards, nice stiff hip angle, head position is neutral, arms are going to be behind us, then we're going to swing our arms to contact the block, opening our shoulder angle as we hop off the vault. Okay, so the gymnasts are now going to have a go at the preparation that we've set up. So we're going to ask the gymnasts again to be on their knees, and we're going to get the gymnast to create a stiff angle between their shoulders and their knees. When the gymnast does this on the actual vault, there'll be their stiff angle between their feet and their shoulders. Doing this breakdown on the floor is helping the gymnast understand how to keep a tight core and keep an open hip angle as they jump on the springboard to create the block off the ball we want. So the gymnast is going to have their arms behind, the hips open, the head neutral, and then we're going to ask the gymnast to try and swing their arms and block into the block. Good girl. Okay, so moving on to the next progression for handspring vault, we're going to bring the gymnast to the floor area. What we're going to ask them to do is perform the arm swing into the floor, trying to block open for their shoulders and then land in a tight handstand position. So we're creating a block out of the floor, the lift we want to see, and keeping a tight body. So the gymnasts are going to have a go at performing the skill on the floor now. Good girl. And arm swing. Block. Good girl. And good. Okay, so the next progression we're going to use for handspring vault is again going to be on the floor. We're going to use a springboard so we've got a bouncy surface for the gymnast to block off, so it's not too much pressure for their elbows and shoulders. And we're going to try and pop up onto a raised platform, showing the heels slightly over the head in a good position, and then landing onto the soft mat. So we're looking at the arm swing, the block, and the body tension. Arm swing. Very good. Swing. Another progression we can use on the floor with the springboard and the mats is after the gymnast has blocked off the springboard and hopped up onto their back on the soft mats, we can then take the gymnast through the motion of standing them up on their feet. So this will be like they're blocking off the vault, lifting off the vault, and then landing in a safe position on the soft mat. So good arm swing, a good pop, and then a safe landing. Okay, so another progression we can use for handspring vault is using a fast track. It could be a tumble track, it could be a trampoline, it could be a floor area. Whatever you have in the gym to use is fine. We're going to use the softer surface on the fast track today because we're going to try and connect a lot together. So again, it's softer for the gymnast's wrists and elbows. So the idea of the exercise is the gymnast will do a handstand, then they're going to do a donkey kick back to handstand, showing a good heel drive and an arm swing at the same time, landing in a tight position. The idea of this is it simulates everything that we're going to use for the handspring vault. So a good arm swing, a good heel drive, and a nice tight handstand. So the gymnast is going to have a go at performing the exercise for us now. So we're looking at the arm swing and the heel drive. Very good. Another progression we can use for handspring vault is using a block that's got a firm surface, a soft safety landing mat on the floor, to look at the arm swing and the block. The gymnast is gonna swing their arm block into the hard vaulting block and travel away from the block, keeping a stiff body and landing in tension on the mat. This is just to work on the arm swing, the block and the body tension. Okay? Good try. Try it when you go. Pop. Okay, so moving on to the next progression for handspring vault, we're now gonna ask the gymnast to go into more of a vaulting situation. So we're gonna have more of a run, a jump onto a proper springboard. We're gonna use the mats here today because they're quite firm to block off of, and we're gonna use a soft raised mat for the gymnast to look at the block and raising up so they feel the travel off the vault and land in a handstand on the gray mat. This will give the gymnast a good idea of how to run, how to swing their arms, and how to block before they leave the vaulting table. Okay, so moving on to another progression for handspring vault, we're now actually using the vaulting table, a proper springboard, and still using a stack of mats at the moment. So we can look at now developing the speed in the run, the arm swing as they jump onto the springboard, the body stiffness, the handstand position, and can we get the height off the table to land flat onto our back? This will show us if the gymnast has got enough block off the table, ready to take the mats away to do the full handspring vault. Okay, when we get to this stage, the gymnast is going to be performing the skill on their own, unaided. We still have the vaulting table and we have a soft stack of mats. This means the gymnast is nice and safe to try the skill, and we can really look at all of the key areas, where they're blocking, where they're looking, are they lifting off the vault? So we know that they're ready to take the stack of mats away and finish the final vault. Okay, so we're moving now on to the final progressions for handspring vault. The gymnast is going to perform the full skill over the vaulting table using a proper springboard, the table and a soft safety landing mat. When we support the skill, we're going to take the second half, the flight off of the vault, taking the gymnast around their core, guiding them off the table through a tall handstand position into a soft, safe landing. Okay, so the final progression now, the whole vault. So the gymnasts are going to perform the skill unaided, again with a soft safety landing mat, so that it's soft for their landing for their knees, but the gymnast is going to do the full run, the arm swing, the block, and trying to land the vault all by themselves now. Hi guys, I hope all of the preps and preparations we've done for handspring vault have been helpful. Please take them away and use them in your gyms and enjoy it.